Hi and welcome. This is Made of Yarn podcast. My name is Lotte and I'm from Sweden. And this will be about knitting and crochet. And this is also episode 31. Last time I talked about that it was the 30th episode, of course, then, and that I have been podcasting for 2 years. So this episode I will tell you which one I had this random number generator thing, which one will get the giveaway. I will show you soon that. I will show you some what I have been knitting and crocheting on, of course. In the end, I will take you to a village not far from here. If you've been here before, a year ago, I made also some footages and a film from that area. Because every year, it's a little village called Kilafors. And they have, in August every year, they call Farmer on the Village. So some of my family members wanted to go there because they have so much fun going on there, but they have also a yarn store that I like to go to, and they have always a catwalk. So you will see in the end, I filmed a little bit and put something together, so just can see what they made. It's quite fun, lovely to see, but that will be in the end. So can we start again, as we usually do, what I am wearing. This was not a plan for this day, but I took it from my wardrobe. I got it back from my daughter, who took it from me a year ago or so. This is a Gudrun Johnston pattern, Audrey in Unst. I test knitted this some years ago when it came out. It's in merino wool yarn, dandelion yarns here from Sweden, yeah. But it's I cannot stand up because I just have leggings on, so I will not show you. But I am on Ravelry, Lotte Blom, and on Instagram, Hjort av Garn. So you can. There are more photos of me in that, if you like to see more of it, I mean. But it's lovely, lovely to wear, but actually I really didn't enjoy to knit it that much because I like more rougher yarns. This was many say it's like to knit in butter, and that's true, but it gets more slippery somehow. But it's to wear it, lovely, really, I love it. I have test knitted three times for Gudrun. This one I can put in so you can see a little, I can't remember for the moment, I didn't prepare this, a little cardigan for my brother's granddaughter Daisy that I made also after she grew too much. I made a new one because they really love the pattern, the design, the cardigan, sorry. And then I also made a sweater for myself that I actually gave away because it was too short in the sleeves. I didn't like it. I will make a new one probably because I really loved it. I can't remember the name of that one either, but you have something to see here. Gudrun is one of them. If you not been here before, in the beginning when I started this channel, I actually interviewed, I sent questions to designers that I had test knitted for, and got answers back, and I asked also Gudrun, and she said yes, but she always have so much to do, the poor woman. Not poor, it's good, because she do so much lovely things. But I don't have the heart to ask her again. But if you are curious, in previous episodes, I have interviewed with quite a lot interviews. Not with one live, so to say, a Swedish one, but also that's in English. Christine Blom, we are not related. But if you like to go back, you can see it's Tracy Miller, it's Lee Esselström from Finland. I can't remember anymore. I can't remember. It's so many. I just came to think about two. I'm sorry. But just go back and check. A little warning, if you also are new here, I have a problem with concentration and so on, because I had to cut, because I can't talk sometimes. But I just, if you are new here, I can just warn you that I am chronically ill, and I have problem with to remember things and concentrate and so much more. But I will do my best. So I'm grateful that you that you have patience and are still here, hopefully. I will continue to talk about much more. I had also said that I would love to, my plan is to knit 12 pairs of socks of Tracy Miller that I have test knitted much before, over the years. So 12 pairs, I don't know how many I have for the moment, and I don't know if I've shown this finished. This is the Coffee Talk socks that I actually also made in, not in fingering, but in sport weight. And you have to show you the something wrong there. Why did I do purl stitch there? We take the other one. I knit in sport weight. I like this. This is the Finnish wool, Novita Nalle. I said it also before, but I follow the smallest size and have needle in millimeter, 2.5 millimeter needles, and that I get a perfect fitting sock for me. So this one is the Coffee Talk socks, and then I made also these On the Porch socks, also in Novita Nalle. I didn't know, but when I checked on Ravelry and also Tracy herself wrote it when I showed this one on Instagram, that this pattern are free. It's an easy pattern, but it's just slipped stitches. But it's something is happening and it's fun. When I test knitted this, I tried the Norwegian yarn Rauma Gammelserien. That is just 100% wool, harder spun, but I destroyed them after 5 minutes, kind of. They got hole directly. I couldn't. For me, it wasn't a good yarn choice to work in. Perhaps to have as a bed sock or something like that when it's just wool. I wear my socks really, I get holes really fast, actually. But, so this is two pairs to put in my, I have them in a shoebox for to see how many I get. I will have 12 when the year is finished, how do you say? In December I will have 12 pairs. I will wait on the bus. Sorry. I have knitted more socks, but I don't have them here. One is for... Sorry. One is for a... How should I say? My nephew David, he's my neighbor also, has his daughter here from Guatemala, Annette, and her boyfriend Alejandro also visited here 1 week. And I asked Annette if he liked knitted socks, and she said he does. So I started to knit to give him before he went home. But I missed him that day, but she is still here, so she will give them to him. Just an ordinary vanilla sock with stripes in blue and gray. But he saw them on, she FaceTimed him, and he was glad for that. And then I gave the socks to David, my nephew, and he said, "Why don't I ever get anything from you?" No, he hasn't. Can you make something with orange? Of course, I have started socks striped also, black and orange, rusty orange for him also. And then I said that to his wife Sonja, and she said, "No, you haven't made anything for me either." I think I made for everyone in the family, but not for them. I don't really know why. But now I will do it, because next year we have special anniversaries, both David and Sonja, my nephew and his wife. They have been married 30 years. Me and my husband, Pio, we have been married 40 years in June next year. And my brother, Rude, and his wife, Ingela, have been married 45 in October next year. And my oldest brother, Torbjörn, and his wife, Yvette, have been married 55. So I will probably ask them if there's something that they want me to knit or crochet, if they want a sweater, cardigan, or a blanket, or anything. Because I asked my oldest brother when they had 50 years, it's golden wedding, and they wanted sweaters. So I made that for them then, but it's... And now 4 years ago then. But I have about a year for someone to make something. So I will ask them if they have anything special they want. Sorry, I have to drink something also. But then I had... talking about Annette, she is from Guatemala, she lives there. I didn't know first that she should come here, but when I heard it, I asked if she wanted something, also if I could make her something, knit her something, whatever she liked. So I sent her some suggestions, can't pronounce it correctly. And she wanted the Sevilla blouse from Petit Knits. So I made that. I haven't, for the moment right now, haven't taken any photos of her yet. But I will do it any day. So when I am editing this video, I will put in. So you can see her in the one. So it's a mix. The yarn is a mix. It's a Swedish yarn, Järbo Collin, and that's cotton and linen. One thread of that and one thread of Holst Super Soft in white. The cotton linen is beige and a white strand of Super Soft. And the fabric was really nice, and really, really nice. So I have had to do some for myself also, and my daughter Lovisa wants one also. And so something here, someone have jumped down here. I don't know if you can see. She was sitting here before, but now she was here. This one also is a frog from Claire Garland. I can't remember the name on Instagram. But I will put down. I will write it so you know. Annette, so before she, also that I knew that she would come here to Sweden, she sent me a video because many make these ones and make such fun videos that when they are moving and doing things. So I said, I have the pattern, I can make one for you. And now I made one when she's here, but she hasn't got it yet because I wanted to show you her before. And I made also just a dress with no pattern. I don't know her name yet. Annette said we have to choose a name together. I said perhaps Fiona. But her father David said Henna. So I don't know. Perhaps it's Henna the frog. I was surprised when I started to knit because in my eyes, she's tiny, but in my eyes she's big because I've seen so many that are really small. But then I understand that they are just working with one strand of yarn. I had two strands, so that's after the pattern. So that's why she is perhaps double the size. And then I put a wire, what is it called? A hard wire inside, so you can in the legs, not in the arms. You couldn't do that also, but I didn't have the patience for that. But I don't have the really frog eyes. I just have this, but it's a security eyes, but just black ones. I don't know if you can see them even. But this a little froggy. She's a cute one. Sorry, I check my notes again. I have started a sweater for my daughter Louisa. She has problem with it. Took time before she even dared to say to me when I knitted for her that she can't wear wool. It's okay with merino. But then I actually bought, I can show you here, it's a Danish company, but they are selling now in Sweden because it's called Mayflower, I don't know it, I guess they are also in English, Mayflower, because I bought before they have, now they have a website and they are quite new here in Sweden, a Swedish website. But before I bought sock yarns and so, but now they have, so I can order directly from them, and they have really good prices. What I should say, this is, you can see, an enormous scale. This is 300 grams, and it's in yards, 786 yards, 860 meters. It's almost 1 kilometer, almost long. But I take two strands from it, and then I'm making, here, I came so far, here, I don't know how good you can, well, you can see it. I started in the back. This is a pattern from Sandnes Garn, from this one. It's the hazel dress, but I will just make it as a sweater. Let's see if I have the, so you can see the, here are the, one of the photo. Here. Can you see it there? An oversized, because I can put in a photo here, because Louisa saw this online and she said, can you make it? Of course I can make it, but to find, she wanted also the correct pink color, and that wasn't easy at all. And also when I have this, are limited to choose from yarns. But then I ordered, I checked online on this Mayflower, and then I saw this yarn color, and it's slightly about the same. And she's glad over it. It will be longer back. But long arms. I mean, it will be really cozy. So I'm knitting the largest size with double, so it will be perhaps bigger than also the largest size are in the pattern. I have to have the skein in my knee and take one from the inside. So I'm pulling one to the right, and then I have the other thread over. I had to just take it over so that it not will be any mess in the middle. So I am so careful when I'm knitting with it. I have also to show you, because we have, let me throw this away. We have this Swedish company, big Swedish company called Edna. And they have their main brands are Svarta Fåret and Järbo. And every year, a couple of times a year almost, since I have been asked when they have a new collection, if they are asking, many of us who have podcasts, if we like to have something from them. And knit or crochet, whatever, and they give us, they always have these patterns free also in English, but they will give me yarns also for that project. I will dive. I have here, for example, I have some, this is a new, it's not a new yarn, but I haven't knitted it in it. It's a Tencel Blow from Svarta Fåret. It's Tencel and Alpaca. And that will be a hoodie. I don't have the pattern here, but I can show you a photo. And it's out now, and also, as I said, in English and many languages also. But that will be a fade. We have that one, and also this is Cecilia. It's like Sandnes Line, for example, or Drops Bell. It's cotton, viscose, and linen. So it's one thread. I have one other color, a beige one also. So we'll marl it or have a gradient in it, so it will be lovely. And that's also for my daughter Lovisa. She is outside more than I am. And then we got some, we asked if we wanted to choose something. They have new colors of many of their yarns. So this is sock yarn, raggy. These ones are the 3-plied svensk or Swedish wool in new colors for this year. And this is one of the 2-plied Swedish wool, and that also are, before they had, I don't know where they bought the yarn from, but it wasn't from Sweden, but now it is Swedish wool in them. Nice. And I got some more also sock yarns to try. So you get spoiled a couple times a year from the company Edna. I'm so grateful for that. I had to check again. Talking about yarns, in southern of Sweden, it's a place called Klippan. I had never been there before, but my niece Renée visits every summer her best friend who lives in the southern of Sweden in Malmö. but it's not, it's quite near this yarn store, a factory actually called Klippan. They are making blankets also, but they are selling yarn and they have outlets. So I asked Renée a couple of years when she got out, do you think you will come to Klippan? And once she tried, but she didn't come, she didn't, what is the word? They closed before she came there. Because it's almost, is it 800 or 900 kilometers from here down there, so it's quite far to go. But anyway, we FaceTimed and I started to drool. I wanted everything. But then in the end, I said to my daughter Louisa, she sat beside me, I said, what did I choose? I don't remember. And Renée said, we will see when I come home. She had bought for me and her 42 skeins. It's really about €3, €3 ish, 35 Swedish kronor. When she came home, I had chosen this. I know now that I did. Oh, can you see? It's a heavy, heavy bag. I had just one of this bluish turquoise. I will probably have in some color joked color. But then I have five of each. It's 100 gram skeins. So this one I like. Oh, it fits my nail polish. I have this one I really like. I have I have one that I recorded in Swedish. I'm almost afraid for this one. It's so yellow. I thought perhaps I don't have anything yellow, and I really don't know if I will make something clothes wise. Probably can be a blanket. That's the good thing, that you can do whatever you like. But the other colors are, I really love them. I don't have any plans for them yet, but something, it will be something. And I will, if you've been here before, you know, inside here I have my craft room, and in the back I have shelves that I have yarn in, that I have usually as my background. But I will take away some of, because much of them they are brown, they are gray, they're quite boring. So I will have something more that pops when you come back next time. Oh, so I am not without work, knit the following couple of years at least. I have to check again. I don't know, I moved it here, you can see. This is something that is too big to show you here. But this is a temperature blanket from 1999 that I made for my youngest daughter Amanda. She wanted a blanket in blue, in yellow and light pink, but it wasn't that much pink. It was really much of yellow, so that what is that called? I didn't have enough. So I asked if I could take another one. It was okay. But then when that one didn't have enough of that one, I had to stop there. And then I continue to this. Actually, it's just 10 months, because I asked that man because it's so long, and I will put in a movie soon of my daughter Louisa. She's standing on, we have a little cottage here on my on our yard, and she is rolling it down so you can see how big it is, because Amanda will just have it on a I'm trying again to find the word, not on a sofa, just a, is it a couch, just a chair? So it couldn't be that big, but 10 months at least it is. And then also here, that stripe is from August 12th when she was born. I made that in also with some fluff too, so you can see it a little different there, but I will put in that little short film. So you can see it will be a nice thing for her to have in winter to warm herself. Then I also started one for Louisa, who was born 1997, also in August. But she's the one who are sensitive then to wool. I made her blankets before in wool, and she can feel sometimes when she have fallen asleep having it over her or laying on that, she feels that her asthma is, she feels her asthma. So I am actually knitting also in this acrylic yarn that I showed before. Did I say that it was acrylic? Perhaps I didn't do that. So this is the first, here you can see three colors. It's just four colors in the whole blanket because she does want them. So it's that one, these three colors, and this one. So this one is for the warmer months, the summer months. So let's see, this one I guess will be even bigger. But I said to Louisa, if perhaps at least I can get to August at least, and it's, well, perhaps for to the day when she's born. So we will see how big it will be and how far this yarn will take me. But it's fun with, I like knitting and crochet. This is crocheted blankets. I really love them. And it's also a good gift for others. I'm so sorry, I had to, but just check here. It's just more, I have Swedish notes because we have a kind of knit-a-thon, but in Swedish. If you're here and understand Swedish, I know some Danish are here because they understand English better than Swedish, but in October 19th to 20th we have a Swedish podcaster, Mary Lou Knitting. She will have a 24 hours online knitting over Google Meet. She will have more information on her channel. But perhaps if you know Swedish, it could be understand a little bit, it could be fun, because she will talk also to other podcasters. As this is a little bit like Pia Trans in Denmark have this knit-a-thon, but just in Swedish then, and over then also Google, but some perhaps also choose to have over, make something over YouTube. I haven't decided yet what I will do. Other podcasters who can just help to make the time go. I will absolutely not knit 24 hours, but as much as I can, of course, and it's fun. And I have talked to some yarn companies and crafters here in Sweden also, if they can be sponsor some gifts for that event also. So the October 19-20, for those who understand Swedish, it will be on Marie Lou Knitting podcast. Well, I will I forgot to show you here. I bought from Finnish Novita company, Novita. I bought this. It's a Moomin. It's a set. You just knit a hat and you have a label. And also you get a postcard, but a label with Moomin on. I will make this for my daughter Lovisa's sister-in-law. She loves Moomin. So a nice little gift, perhaps. That one is Vibeke 1939 from Denmark. Congratulations. If you can write to me, perhaps, on Instagram, I get your address, and I will send you a little package with stitch markers that my daughter made and some small balls of that I made from that I hand dyed from natural dyeing. Just a slightly appreciations for you being here. I wanted to make something for you all, but I said it also on the Swedish episode that it don't have to be a special occasion to give gifts. When our children were small, with the most, when people know that they are getting gifts, they know it and they are tensed and okay, thank you. But to do this with as a surprise, it's the best. Just to say, I want to give you this because I love you, I appreciate you, just thought of you, yeah, something like that. And I will do the same also with you. Just now and then, give something away. I don't have no plans for the moment, but something, it will be something in the end, not in the end, now and then. I thought that I put my phone on. I get messages, I'm sorry. But I have almost finished my talking. I will just tell you that I will be back in September. But if you still continue to see, you can see the catwalk from our neighbor village, Kilafors. I'm so grateful that you are visiting me here. I'm so grateful for you, all of you who have been here for 2 years, and all of you new ones. And if you are not a subscriber, and if you like this, even though I'm all over and like this, if you like that anyway, I'm grateful if you make the thumbs up. And subscribe, of course. That helps me to grow. It's not easy for me with the English one. It's some problem. Some of you, thank you, you know who you are, have actually, I almost cried. It was so sweet. She wrote to me that she wrote messages to about 50 friends and other podcasters also that they should look me up. Thank you so much. I got some new ones, but it's real. I don't know what's the problem. It's with the algorithm or something in YouTube. But I will not complain that for you. I'm sorry, but it's just my. I don't know why it's such a problem. But so if you like, that's why I should say it. That helps me to grow. If you hit the thumbs up and subscribe. But thank you so much again. I hope I could have inspired for something. I don't know, but and that you have the nice knit or crochet or did whatever you did when you watched. But lean back here and watch a catwalk in Sweden in August, and we will see each other in September. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.
Här och se om det är någonting som passar. Så luta dig tillbaka, för kör vi igång.
Thank you.